Hello, my name's Des Shipp, and I'm going to run you through a nice little guide today all about method feeder fishing. I'm going to run you through the gear, all the bait, how to load the feeder, everything that you need to put more fish in your net. First thing I'm going to do is clip up. I can actually chuck to the far bank of this lake, so if you're chucking to an island or you'd go into a venue where you chuck to the other side of the lake, it's really important you learn how to clip up correctly. So what I got on there on me line already to go is the ICS inline tube, so it's really easy to, you know, go from a feeder to a straight lead. But the first thing I'm going to do is want to clip up. I'm not going to use a method feeder, I'm going to use a bomb. So what I do is take the tail rubber off. This is how quick and easy this stuff is. I got a 30 gram bomb on there, so I just put that on the tube, put the tail rubber back on like that. So I'm ready now to actually get the distance of what I need to fish to the far bank. So first thing first, I'm not cast out yet. I've not got a line clip on. So the first thing I'm going to do is try and get as close as I can. Obviously, don't go too far. Cast out like that. I'd probably say that was probably about 3 or 4 meters off. So I'm just going to let a little bit of line out like that and then put my line clip on. And obviously if I cast that a bit closer, I'll just take a little bit less line off the reel and then clip up. So I'm going to have another cast there. That's the beauty about this system. Before that, I'd be casting out a method feeder. With this, you can just chuck a little bomb out. That's probably, I would say, a meter off. I want to go a little bit closer. So I'm just going to take the clip off that I put on. Just take about 3 turns off the spool and then put your line clip back on. And you can just do that and get it dead right. Because that's a 30 gram bomb on there. So when you put like a 20 gram feeder on and the ground bait, you've probably got roughly between 30 and 50 grams on the rod. So there's not a lot of difference. So I'm going to cast that again. Now to me, that was perfect. It's probably about that far off. And as I go through the session, if I wanted to adjust that, I can either like take a little bit of line off and put the clip back on, or if I want to come a little bit further off the bank, I can obviously just take a couple of winds and put the clip back on. But I'm going to start there. That looked really nice. I'm just going to have one more cast just to make sure everything's right. So like that. Cast that again. Perfect. I think that's like 2.5 foot off, I would say. I think today, because the wind's still nippy, I think that's a good starting point. And I can just vary that as I go along. So what I do now, I've got my bomb on there. Take the tail rubber off. Take my inline bomb off. Like that. I've got my little 30 gram method feeder. Put that on my stem. Put the tail rubber back on. So within seconds, I've got my method feeder on, all ready to go. Well, as we all know, one of the most important things about method feeder fishing is getting your bait right. And the first thing I'm going to do is mix my ground bait up. Two of my favourite ground baits is F1 Green and Match Method Mix. And what I like to do is mix these 50-50. It's something I've been working on for several, you know, I sort of get out of my garage, I mess about with different mixes, and this is my favourite mix. And what I use is a little container like that. That's probably just over a pint. And you can vary this as you go, but I'm going to mix that thing up about 1.5 of each ground bait. So one of them, I'm going to fill that up about halfway with the green F1, like that, and I'm going to put the same as the Match Method Mix in. So you just basically got a 50-50 mix. So one of them, like that, and a half. And the nice thing about this as well, one, you don't waste bait, and two, once you get your ground bait right, you can add as much water. You can sort of get your water right. So I'm going to mix them two round. And I know from past experience, if I put about 3/4 of one of them of water in, it works out perfect. So about 3/4 of water like that. Tip that in. And I can vary that when I get to be peg, and when we start talking about when I'm fishing, I can vary sort of, I can put a little bit more water in my mix, especially on a day like today. It's nice and warm and it's very windy, and your ground bait will dry out. So I'm gonna mix that round quickly like that. Just make sure all the dry ground bait at the bottom of the bucket, always use a nice biggish bucket, that'll always help. As simple as that. And that's nice now, that's just nice. So what I'm gonna do now, there's my method, I got out my match method mix bag. I'm gonna stick that on a riddle. Just drive that through a riddle. Really important you put it through a riddle. Takes all the lumps out. Like that. Push the rest through. And there you go. And if I want to vary that, I can vary that when I'm fishing. But there you go, that's the finished bait. Absolutely perfect. It's not too wet and not too dry. I do like it on the dry side when I'm using a method feeder. And that, to me, as you can see, once that's on a method, it's absolutely perfect. Well, the next bait I want to get right for the method feeder is me 2mm pellets. Now, I've got me bag of 2mm thin perfect pellets there. I've got me pellet wetter to go, and it doesn't get any easier than this, believe me. So what I'm going to do, just open the bag up. You can obviously measure out how many you want. I'm going to do about half a bag, something like that, which I think is going to probably be enough for today. Stick that out of the way. So I've put them in the pellet wetter sock, zip it up, and what I like to do is leave them. I've got me EVA bowl there full up with water, and I like to leave me pellets in there probably about 10-15 seconds. Everybody's got their own little preference about that. So I'm going to put the pellet wetter in the water, give them a shake so they all sink, leave them for about 10-15 seconds. It's really, really easy, like that. So 10 seconds, lift them out. And then shake all the water off, because that's what happens sometimes. The water at the bottom of the container, the pellets get really soaky and horrible at the bottom. With this, you can just shake the water off. Just like that, tip that water away. This is what I'm gonna put my pellets in. Undo the zip. You can tip them in there or just leave them in there, leave them in that sock if you want. And what I'll do then is leave them for about 10 minutes and they'll be absolutely perfect to go around the method feeder. I'm just going to go through how to load the feeder. I get asked a lot on the bank, you know, how do I load the method up with the mould? So I'm going to show you now exactly what I do. Obviously, I've got my components here. I've got my ground bait and my 2mm pellets. I'm going to start with the ground bait first. And what I do, my favourite way of doing it, is I half fill the mould like that. And then with this feeder, obviously you've got the area in the middle where your hook bait goes. So you put your bait in the middle, your hook bait in the middle. Then fill your mould up with ground bait like that. And what I like to do is just crush that down with my finger. If it goes down a little bit, just put a little bit more ground bait over the top. So pat that down, not really hard. So it's like that. One of the most important ways is you've got to have that line coming out the same way. So where your quick change bead is, you can see the line coming out of the mould. It's really important you do that. Then press the feeder into the mould like that, really hard. And then press the button. And that's why you don't want your ground bait too wet. If you have your ground bait too wet, sometimes it can stick in the mould. If you get it so it's on the dry side, and I can vary that, then that's why I've got that tub of water there. I'm gonna just flick a bit of water in like that, mix it around just to keep it dead right throughout the day. And there you go, it's absolutely perfect. And all I do then, before I cast out, just give that a quick squeeze and I'm ready to go. Well, that was an absolute steaming bite, that. I'm just going to talk you through the terminal tackle that I'm using. I've got obviously a little 30 gram method feeder on. I'm fishing with 017 reflow power hook length, 4 inches of that. And I've got a 16 PR 36, just with a little Dura band on. So it's really, really easy. You can just put a little band on there or a hard pellet. And I'm using a little monster carp feeder rod, 10 footer. It's an absolute lovely little rod, to be honest. Cool. Let's pulling hard. I've got 8 pound, it's a new line, it's called sinking feeder line. Something that I've been working over the winter with Preston, it's absolutely brilliant. It sinks really, really quickly and it's mega, mega tough. And that little rod, lovely bit of kit, absolutely perfect for what I'm doing today, chucking about 35 metres to the far bank for F1s and carp. Fighting like a demon as every other fish that I've caught up to now, to be honest. And I've literally put that rod at the moment. I've only just started fishing, really. A lot of people ask me, how do I start? What do I put on the method? And normally in matches, I always start with 2 mil pellets around the feeder and like a bandom on the hook. And I'll take it from there. And I do that because I think if there's some big carp feeding early in the match, I think sometimes the 2 mils are best. And then I'll take it from there, really. Obviously, change the ground bait, change to like 50-50 mix of ground bait and micros. On their day, they all make a difference. But at the moment, I'm just sticking with the 2 mils. Look at that. Lovely. Lovely Woodlands View carp. You see the pink bandom. Oh, pink bandom's a real good bait for me. You seem to catch a lot of fish on that bait, to be honest. Well, look, just chuck that out of the way. I'll try and hold them up for you. Every fish we've caught here today, up so far, have been absolutely pristine. Lovely fish to catch. Fight. Ridiculous. Not very happy about being picked up, but I'm going to try anyway. Oh, look at that. Absolute beauty. Woodlands View carp, bitch, white witch. Brilliant. Let's see if I can get another one. We're just going to run you through now what I'm doing with my method. Loading the feeder with micros is very similar to what you do with the ground bait. And like I've done at the start of the session, I only soak my pellets just for about 10 seconds. There's a reason for that, because I don't want them to turn to mush. Them pellets have been sat in there for a couple of hours now, and they're still like pellets. So what I do, if they dry out slightly, same principle as what I'm doing with the ground bait. I've got a tub of water there. Just flick a few drops in like that. Spin that first couple of inches down like that and they'll stick straight away. But the same principle, I've got me mold. I like to fill me mold up about halfway with micros. Put me bait in the middle of the same. It's a bit harder than ground bait to get your pellets right. But cram them in with your thumb like that. Just push them down. Put your feeder in the mold. A big squeeze, a bit harder to squeeze in when you're using with micros. Like that. Absolutely perfect. Now, one good little tip I do sometimes, and this can you can do it with ground bait and you can do it with micros, is you can double load the feeder. So what I do to do that is put some more pellets in the mold, probably just below halfway. Don't put too many in because otherwise you can't sort of squash them down enough. So I put the feeder back in the mold like that and give it another squeeze. And that can be deadly some days. Just getting back out your mold like that. So basically, you've got like two wraps of bait. Now, you can even do that with ground bait. I can put micros on first and then sort of double load with ground bait. It's a great little tip. Sometimes that's what I like about method feeder fishing. You've got a few different baits, but you can do a lot of different things with it. So double loading is one of them. And there again, just another squeeze. Squeeze it on. I've got, you know, it's quite a lot of bait on there now. And you... when that goes in, it's still the same sort of principle. It goes in with like a proper clunk. I don't want, you know, trying to keep as much bait on there as I can. You can feel that, it's like kadoom, and that's what you want. Because you want to try and keep as much bait on that feeder as possible. A nice little tip I'm going to show you now is get yourself organized on your side tray. As you can see from my side tray here, I've got all my bait, I've got some bandoms, I've got some hard pellets all ready to go. Spare feeders. I've got my ground bait in one bowl, my 2 mils in another. I've even got a bowl at the front with some extra ground baits. I don't want to be messing around when I'm fishing. You know, I've even got a bowl of water there. So if like a day like today, it's very windy, it's sunny, your bait's going to dry out. So I've got a bowl of water there. I can just flick a bit of water in. I can adjust my mixes as I go. I've even got an empty EVA bowl there. If I want to do a mix of 50-50 micros in ground bait, it's there ready to go. Spare hooks. And believe me, if you do this, it will definitely make it easier for you on the bank. So just cast out, pick me little marker, cast out as it hits the clip, straight down. I put my bell arm over with my hand, make sure the line is in the roller, and just watch the line. And I use the rod like that to sink the line. And that line's going down really quickly, which is important. So I'm ready to go now. Just get my rod rest in the right position. So I'm ready to go, and all I'm gonna do now is get me molding me 2 mils, fill that halfway up, and I'm ready to go again. It's them little things while I'm waiting for that rod. You know, I see a lot of people, even nowadays, they get a few little indications. There might be a fish pecking at the feeder, or it might be a liner like that on their rod. When you're method feeder fishing, it ain't like that. You need to keep your hands on your hands on your knees or on your legs, wait for the correct bite. Some bites are like sort of knocking like that, and it just keeps knocking, and that one's on. A lot of the bites, as we all know, are properly aggressive, but you don't need to keep doing that. And don't strike its head off. When you get a bite, it don't matter what sort of bite it is, just pick the rod up. You know, method feeder fishing is all about, like that fish is on. So all you need to do is pick it up, see how big it is. I'm not sure. I've got the back wind on at the moment, but once I hook a fish, I take it off. Because what you don't want is your reel going backwards and you end up getting a tangle. And I'll run you through that now. When I've played this one and got this one in, I'll show you exactly what I do. I don't think this is as big as the last one. Might be an F1. There's a few F1s in this. There's all sorts. Little stockies. That's the nice thing about it. You don't know what you're going to catch next. And I keep your rod low until I get the fish in range of me landing net. Oh, it's not as small as what I thought that, actually. Unbelievable. That thing has fought nothing like the other one. It's probably near on the same size by the feel of that. So keep your rod. Obviously, when the fish gets near you, you've got to start lifting the rod up. Obviously got me back wind off, got me clutch set. This is a good time now to sort of adjust your clutch. I've obviously caught a few fish now, so my clutch is set, just in case it does sort of lunge real fast, the clutch will work. But I normally play them with the reel, to be honest. I feel like I'm more in control with that. So the carp's now probably landing net range, it's not quite ready. Feels like a good fish, probably as big, if not bigger than the last one, unbelievable. And that's just nodded really until I've got it 10 feet from the bank. Look at that, beautiful. And getting your gear right, you know, get the right reel, the right line, the right rod, and you can have a brilliant day. I love this, even pleasure fishing, I think it's brilliant. You can come with just a little bit of bait, a few hook baits, and you can have one of the best days fishing you've ever had. But you need the right gear, you know, 8-pound line, nice little 10-foot rod. Yeah, beautiful fish that. A little bit bigger than the last one. So what I do now, I've got my rod, me sort of as much line out as I have my length of my rod. I'm now going to put the back wind on. Because if you don't, the reel will go backwards and you end up getting a right state. Obviously, go careful with your landing. And it's quite a big fish, that, actually. Pull that one in. Put that on your lap. Now, I can put that under my bum cheek like that. So I've got both hands now. You don't need to put that down. A lot of people put their rods down. Even when they're fishing with the pole, they put their top kits down. You don't need to do it. Just get a little system in. Get a little system that you can do. Use a disgorger. A lot of the time I use a disgorger when the fish are in the land, and that I just think it's a lot easier. Like that. Take the hook out. I'm going to try and hold this one up. Again, because he's a beauty. Probably 8. No, he's probably 8 pound, that one. And the sun's just gone in, so that might help him stay still. Look at that. What a beauty. Little method feeder. 2 mils round it, don't get any better than that. Well, the next shot, I've had them two big ones. I can't believe some of these fish. I thought that was tiny. And I just caught, I literally chucked the feeder out and I couldn't, the line was just completely slack. And I tried to wind a couple of times, it wouldn't tighten up. Just picked the rod up and there was one on. And that's what's so good about this little monster carp feeder rod. You know, I've caught two fish for 15 pound and now I got a little pound F1. That's what's so good about these little rods. You can catch big fish, you can catch little fish. Little F1, still on a pink bandom again. You see his little pink bandom then just popped out of his gob. I don't even have to rebait, I can just use that again. So a few micros in the mold. Compact it over with your thumb like that. You can even put a few more in because you want to make it so it's really compact around that feeder. Push them in, press your little button. Little squeeze. Like I said, cast out. When you think it's going to hit the clip, bosh, down. Put your rod on your rod rest. And then use the end of the rod under the water to sink your line. And like I said, with that new feed line as well, it sinks unbelievable. I'm only fishing in probably 2 foot of water over there. On your rest. Got it on my butt rest. And I'm ready to fish. I can then get me feeder or get me mold ready for the next chuck. If your ground bait's drying out, I'll just get a bit of water like that on my fingers and keep everything. There we go. No need to strike. That actually swam towards me then for a little bit. That feels. Take your back wind off. It's all a little system. Keep your rod low. If the fish is running to the left, and put your rod down to your right and just keep everything nice and low, nice. Just wind into the fish, that's what's so good. Have a good reel, wind into the fish. You can see what I'm doing. I'll just come this side to show you. Obviously the fish has gone to the right now. Just take a couple of winds like that. And then when it gets down, like I said, sort of 10, 12 feet from the bank, something like that, lift your rod up. It's a good fish again, that. But just take your time. And then I have got the clutch set, like I said, but I do like playing my fish off the reel. I just prefer that. I feel like I'm in control. Keep the rod down. Lovely little rod, that. It's got a little bit of power in it as well, so it helps you cast in. I always find that with rods with a little bit of backbone in the middle. If you're not very good at casting, rods with a little bit more backbone in the middle will definitely help you. He's getting close now to netting. Nice common, that one. Look at that. Get in there. Some proper chunky fish at the moment. Oh. Let him settle down a minute. You know, respect your fish. Said, let a bit of line out. Back wind on, under your bum cheek like that. Then you've got your two hands then for your fish. Try and use a disgorger. Oh, put me disgorger down. Try and use your disgorger. I just think it makes the job a lot easier. Like that. Try and hold him up again because he's an absolute beauty, that thing. Big gut on it, a bit like me. What an absolutely stunning Woodlands View common carp on the Mefford feeder. Brilliant. Well, these are three of my favourite hook baits for when I'm fishing with the Mefford feeder. The first of which we spoke about, is the bandom. Pink, for me, is one of the best that I've used, especially in clear water. I'm not sure why. I've used this in the winter on method feeder and pellet feeder. It seems to be a great bait. The second one is the good old faithful hard pellet. You know, when they're hard to catch, especially F1s in carp, you can put just a hard pellet on like I have on there. Absolutely brilliant. But one of my all-time favourites, believe it or not, especially when things are very difficult, is maggots with ground bait random method. Absolutely brilliant for catching carp, F1s and bream. And it's really important, you know, get yourself right, the right stance when you're going to cast. Nice little cast like that. Takes time to get this right, but if you go out and practice on a little venue like such as like a little lake today, you'll be surprised after a couple of visits, you'll be much, much better. It's going to move me tip round. I mean, that's on immediately. I mean, you can't believe how quick that had that. And I force them, my crews, on my feeder. That feels like a good fish. Take me back, wind off. I'm so confident. Obviously, I do quite a lot of fishing, so I'm really confident with the gear. But once you get that confidence in your setup, brilliant, absolutely brilliant fish. I love it. Jeez, that's gone off to the left. So bring your rod down to the right. Couple of winds. Got to go a bit careful when you get them down by your neck. If you think it's a big fish, they like that one has. That one's got come in like it's like a 2-pounder, and then it started to wake up. But just keep my hand on my reel like that. Get my finger on your line. I mean, that's things that I've sort of picked up on myself as I've been fishing. You know, you can get them to that stage like that. Just put your hand on your reel like that. Stop it from turning. Feels like another good fish, that. That rod's an absolute pleasure to fish with, to be honest. What I don't want to be doing is bringing the fish to the top, thrashing all over the place. You know, that's when you end up pulling out of them. I'm trying to sort of play them till they're nearly ready and then try and bring them up. I don't bring them up. I see a lot of people that are like, you know, forcing them in and they're on the top, thrashing around, and then they wonder why they come off. I'm trying to keep it down enough to not make it come up when it's not ready. You can see how I'm playing that now. You know, it is coming to the top, but it's not sort of, I'm not bringing his head out. And there he's ready. Just get your net out like that. Job done. Then bring your fish to you. Get your reverse on under your bum. Like that. You don't even have to put the rod down. Use your disgorger. You don't even have to touch the fish, really, to be honest. Like that. Straight in the keep net. Leave that band on again. Straight round. Half fill the mould with micros. Micros is good at the moment, but it can change. But I am catching some big carp, and that happens quite a lot when I'm a method feeder fishing. You go out there, you have some big carp straight away, and then sort of as it goes on, you know, some of the venues I go to, you've got a lot more F1s in there as well. You might have to change mid-match and put ground bait on. Sometimes it's just ground bait, but I always start on those 2 mils. So cast that again, it's a clip down, on your rest, use your rod like that. As long as that line's sinking, don't do anything. If you get a bite, it doesn't matter. You'll know about it. So the line's sunk, down onto your butt rest. And I might just adjust that just a bit. As long as that line's going towards where you've just chucked out, that's enough tension on the line. And then I can just come back to me me mould, half fill the mould again. You know, have a go at your ground bait, make sure that's all right. Perfect. Don't have to do anything. Sit there now. A lot of the bikes now are coming very quickly. Some of the bikes have literally been, the feeder's at the bottom, and I've not had a chance to tighten up to the tip. And sometimes that happens during a match. You might get a spell where you're chucking out, and it's like, oh, this is brilliant. And then all of a sudden it changes. That's when you've got to keep, I mean, you might have to cast more regularly. You might have to change your baits, you know, hook baits, your bait, what you're putting around your feeder. You know, that's what goes through your mind when you're method feeder fishing. That's what's so enjoyable about it. There's lots of things you can do. There's something I do a lot when I'm method feeder fishing. If you've had some fish on the method and things go quiet and you think, well, I want to have a go on the pole, the first thing I want to do is get some bait out where I've been fishing. So what I'm going to do, I'll take this little method off, take your hook length off, which I've already done, and get a big cage on, this big inline cage. They're absolutely superb. So just feed that back on the stem, like that. And I can put either ground bait or micros in. I'm going to put micros in. So in that feeder there, I've probably got like 4 or 5 feeder falls or method feeder falls of 2 mils. And I might cast this out between 4 and 10 times, depending on where I'm fishing, you know, what I think on the day. Brilliant, brilliant way of getting some bait out there. I'm using the same rod, I ain't got to change. So cast that out to the far bank, like that. I'm gonna leave it there just for like 4 or 5 seconds. Just let them pellets come out and then strike your bait out. It's just a great way of priming up your peg, you know, when things aren't quite happening. So like I said, cast that out. Doesn't take long. Might take you sort of a minute, but the rewards can be massive some days. It can drag all the fish from other anglers around you. You know, they're not thinking like that. Like that. Doesn't take long, like I said. Strike it out. So there you go. It's another great little tip about getting loads of bait in your peg when things aren't quite happening. Well, there you go. What an absolute stunning fish to finish the session off. Well, I hope you picked up some great little tips to give a go next time you're out. And I'm sure you can go out and catch creatures like that.